My name's Craig Richey, I'm 25 years old, and my life now revolves around CrossFit and YouTube. I don't think I've ever not had a passion for fitness. I grew up like every standard kid did, playing football and literally just being out and about in the park.
That's crazy.
He's just one of these very, very talented people. He's the more you delve in, he'll start to tell you bits like, oh, I did gymnastics when I was a kid.
Like, I did a bit of karate, I went into that, I got my black belt, and then I did a bit of break dancing, played a little bit of touch rugby.
I did sprinting when I was a kid. I did football when I was, and you're like, oh, okay.
Found kind of bodybuilding when I was around 16, 17, did that up to about 20 years old.
But, you know, it seems like he's one of them guys that just does everything naturally, but when you dig really deep, he's basically just had a really good exposure to sport.
Won Mr. University at physique competition, and then someone introduced me to CrossFit, and at the time I was like, oh.
Anytime you'd see someone with a CrossFit t-shirt on or a pair of nanos, you'd be like off chasing them down the street and be like, oh, you do CrossFit. So he appeared on my Instagram with a rogue t-shirt on.
Someone showed it me and I was like, I don't really know what this is, and then I ended up wearing a rogue top.
And I just said, anytime you want to do CrossFit, come down and see us at CrossFit Faber. And that was kind of the first meeting point.
Okay, like this is where people get injured. This is where people are going to overtrain. This is the people that do that bad form thing that you see on YouTube all the time.
And yeah, he came down and we basically just met his friends and worked out. So it was quite, you know, we kind of hit it off from the start.
And I remember Craig going to the box and coming back in. He says, my word, he says, I've never experienced anything like this. That seemed to be the change of direction he needed.
And then started to understand the concept behind it instead of listening to what everyone else was having to say about it. And then just fell into CrossFit, and from there started vlogging about CrossFit.
I think he found something he loved, and I think he found something which he could create a YouTube channel out of, a successful YouTube channel.
I can't remember my first workout, but I remember there was one workout that had 400 meter runs in it, and I was like, oh, this is going to be super simple. I used to be a footballer. Yeah, little did I know that I'd get my ass kicked by nearly everyone. Yeah, I remember over time I was like, oh, you know, I'm only going to do this CrossFit once or twice a week. I'm going to continue to do my bodybuilding. That's like going to be me. And then literally over time it became three times a week I was doing CrossFit, and then four times a week doing CrossFit. And then it just, my whole life was then just CrossFit. Because it's way more fun.
So I think I started in the February, and I remember meeting Craig in the summer, I think it was. We actually did more of a bodybuilding kind of PT session. And that was a very fundamental point in my CrossFit journey. He kind of gave me the confidence to put more than just five plates on when you're doing a WOD. Because regardless of what movement it was, it could have been a deadlift or an overhead squat. Me and my friends were just five plates all the way, safety first. His training isn't driven for him to look any different. His training is driven by wanting to perform better, go faster, move heavier weights. And it's just a different focus. I think it goes with the whole CrossFit community, that though. I think it kind of brings a certain vibe and support to everything that you're doing with your training.
Vlogging's a really unique thing. I was aware of it, I knew obviously what it was, but it hadn't quite hit CrossFit yet. And you know, me and Craig obviously had conversations about that. There wasn't a CrossFit vlogger out there.
There was a guy called Christian Guzman who at the time was a physique kind of YouTuber. And he was in his dorm. He literally just was doing videos out of his bedroom. And like, I saw him evolve as a person and as a brand and as just like watch him go through life. And I remember watching, I was like, I can do that. And then I did my degree in physiotherapy, came out the other side, and I turned to my dad and I turned to Jasmine and everyone. I was like, I'm gonna have a go at YouTube.
I said, what do you mean? He said, I wanna be a YouTuber. He said, I wanna follow my passion and I wanna go and start making films. I thought, well, okay. I stood back and watched Craig develop and, you know, start from 10 subscribers and eventually now he's got 100,000 subscribers or more. So, and to see that sort of journey has been absolutely unbelievable.
To be honest, it's very, it's just very natural. I mean, when me and Craig first got together, as I mentioned, that was when he transitioned over to CrossFit anyway. So when he did his first Road to the Open series with the channel, that's when we had the initial peak of subscribers and views.
I try and post 5 to 7 videos a week. Yeah, globally at this present time, we have 108,000 subscribers, which is kind of crazy for us to think that myself and Jazz and my dad and everyone like has all come together collectively basically to make this channel and this soap opera of over 100,000 people.
You know, they're just numbers. And then you meet people at competitions and events and you get messages and it's like, wow, you've had, it's incredible. You don't realise the impact you have on these people's lives.
I remember I went with Jazz to a concert at the O2 and that seats 20,000 people. And if you actually see that when you're sat there, I was like, Jazz, every single day someone, we can fill the stadium twice from people that watch the videos.
I'm not a great CrossFitter by any means. You know, I'm relatively standard. I'm a really good trier, as I say.
I think that's the premises behind it. Like, we're achievable.
When you go to do a workout, it doesn't matter who's the fittest in the class, who's the most unfit in the class, because if you push to your absolute limit, you're both going to be in the same pool of sweat at the end of the workout.
You know, I get messages all the time saying, oh, I was in this WOD, but then I kept saying we don't quit over and over in my head, and I got through it. I feel through the channel we've built a community around it. We did a Team Richey Day like half a year ago and 200 people turned up at Faber. Some people drove 6 hours to have a couple of hours to then drive 6 hours home. You know, and then those days where you're like, oh man, like, what am I doing? What is the point in this? You then realize that those 100,000 people behind you are just there doing exactly the same thing.
Team Richey as a whole, I think it's nice because people follow us and when they watch the video, they feel like they're just living our day with us. It doesn't matter if there's one or 100,000 other people doing that at the same time, so long as in that moment they feel a part of what we're doing.
It's a way of living, not just a sport. CrossFit has 100% indirectly enabled me to travel around the world, meet incredible people, inspire so many different people, and create a life. Like, I've found a new passion, and that passion has turned into a job, and that passion has turned into a YouTube channel that affects over 100,000 people and can have an impact on so many different people's lives. Like, I'll get messages of people that are like, I'm going through cancer and your videos are the only thing that keep me going, or I had depression and like, your videos were like the staple that just kept me moving. Like, that's insane.
I would like to think that we are great advocates for CrossFit. Give people the confidence to go out there and just give it a go, no matter what kind of fitness it is.
You help me do this. Then it all becomes real. We got sent a video from a subscriber that got her first box jump. Regardless if the video was there or not, she has put in that work to get that box jump. She believed enough to be able to do that. You know, that's a big thing for a lot of people, getting their first box jump. That beats any medal that you will win. Like, I would take that over winning the CrossFit Games.
Do you know, when I first found CrossFit, it did feel like you were getting hold of something revolutionary and a tool that you could effectively change the world with, and that's what they were doing. And, you know, they were inspiring you to do that. You know, seeing the vlog get traction, that was the real positive thing that, you know, actually, you know, we can be, you know, life-changing, you know, further than these four walls.
I can just see CrossFit exponentially growing. You know, functional fitness is kind of one of those things where it's starting to take over. People are starting to realise that you can be aesthetic, but also you can run, you can swim, you can bike, you can climb ropes, you can Olympic lift. It's just kind of like that added element of fun to training.
I mean, he's created something which I think is very big, making a difference to a lot of people's lives. If he can continue to do this and keep making that difference, keep being humble, keep putting yourself out there, develop this lovely team of people, well, he's done a great job, hasn't he? You can't look and say that's a bad thing. It's a fantastic thing, which will grow and grow and grow, I hope.